Greg, we've seen an exponential growth in tech stocks during the pandemic. It seems that they're almost the only game in town. I'm wondering whether or not you think it's justified, this growth.
Well, it really has been, and you're right. It has acted like it's the only game in town, and it's kind of counterintuitive, but when the news is bad, these stocks have been working, and they seem to keep working on bad news days. And I think the biggest risk to the tech stocks going forward is actually good news. If good news starts happening, the economy goes back to normal, and the rest of the world starts growing again, they could start losing some of the scarcity premium that's been built in the stock. But net-net, I think overall, these tech stocks have actually proven their worth, and they've become the new defensive sector.
So we've seen some of these stocks, like Shopify, I guess, open the year around the $500 mark. They're sitting at around $1,300. Tesla started off around $500. They're at about $1,500 per share. Are they overvalued?
It's interesting when you look at valuation, because a lot of these business models have really changed a lot in the last few months. And certainly trends that were going on in society have really been pulled forward as we've had more e-commerce really come to the forefront and work from home take over. So a lot of these business models, which we're looking at stuff that would happen over 3 to 5 years, it's really been pulled forward and all condensed in the last 6 months. So that has changed the valuation of a lot of these companies, which you can look at from value on a typical DCF. But when you're looking at a discounted cash flow that's been pulled forward that far, you're seeing a lot of multiple expansion. So some of the moves justified, but at the end of the day, in a short-term sense, they are looking incredibly overvalued right now.
We've seen this structural change in terms of the things that you have suggested, in the way that we've been living, the way that we've been working, the way that we've been shopping. If things do worsen, do you see these tech stocks coming out in a post-pandemic world? How are they going to fare then?
Well, I think it's going to be interesting to see, because certainly they've been getting all the flow of funds right now. And a lot of people have recognized that they are one of the few business models that has actually worked in the last 6 months. What will be interesting to see is what happens on the other side, because if things do drag on, we do stay in this more isolationist work from home period for a little longer, we'll see if these business models do still prove out and if whether that's been justified. Conversely, if things do start to get better and people start going back to more normalized, go to restaurants and shopping and go back to the way it was before, they could lose some of their scarcity premium, and they might not be, they might lose some market share that they've been enjoying the last little bit. So it's going to, the economics and the macro sense is really going to have a big impact on how these business models work and what these companies are going to look like.
Let's specifically take a look at some of these guys. We had mentioned Tesla and Shopify. Your thoughts on Alphabet, your thoughts on Amazon, your thoughts on Facebook.
Well, Amazon has been by far been one of the winning business models over the last few years. And it's really shown just how much it has been benefiting from a lot of different trends out there. Certainly, it seems like Amazon's delivering every day to my house. I'm sure it's delivering to a lot of other people's too, because everyone really wasn't going anywhere and you're just ordering everything to your house. So this has really proven out what Amazon's been doing all along. I think the biggest thing also that you can add into both Amazon and also to Microsoft is just how much has shifted to the cloud. And certainly AWS and Azure from Microsoft have really been big things that have saved a lot of companies. Certainly the whole work from home wouldn't have happened if we didn't have so much on the cloud, how the networking has worked, the Zoom calls, which seems everyone's doing these days, are really enhancing a lot of these companies. So I think the AWS has really been the secret weapon from Amazon, and the retail operations, while they get a lot of headlines, aren't really the whole story. Facebook and some of the other companies, I think, have a bit of a risk coming up from more of a regulation point of view. When you're looking at a lot of these companies, and I think if we're starting to see more from a political point of view, I think some of these business models around media and some of the news flow is really going to be potentially be at risk as governments start to clamp down on over-regulation, monopolistic factors. And that is one risk that I think could show up in the second half of the year, especially if we get more and more comments from Democrats might sweep into the House.
Your thoughts on Tesla's trajectory?
Tesla's almost become the ultimate concept stock. It's a stock that everyone seems to have bought into the vision of the new world with electronic vehicles and alternative power supplies. And it's really become the embodiment of this. And certainly everyone also has bought into Elon Musk's vision and what he's done with SpaceX. But it seems like it's a company that's almost moved beyond the valuation levels. When you look at just from a traditional car company valuation, it's hard to make these numbers work. And the market cap of Tesla right now is bigger than the other big five car companies combined. So it's beyond the valuation of just a typical car company. Now, there's a lot of risk. Can they actually get these production levels up? But I think the biggest risk right now is whether these other competitors can actually come up with a car that's going to compete against them. So I think when you're buying in a Tesla at these levels, you're taking on a lot of risk, whether the business model is going to hold, whether it can last through a lot of competition, and what they can actually deliver, because there's no question it's a good product that they've built, but really what you're paying for the stock, I think, is gotten a little out of control.
We saw Shopify gain some ground during this pandemic.
It's going to be really interesting. I think it's really caught in everyone's attention that now Shopify is the largest market cap company in Canada. And when you look at its business versus Royal Bank, you have to wonder, is that really justified? But when you look at it, it's kind of the tale of two different industries, that you've got Royal Bank, which has built a tremendous business serving small to medium and large businesses through Canada. And then you've got Shopify, which is all about small to medium businesses, but it's all really advancing them in the e-commerce space. And as every company really had to shut their physical locations and move online, Shopify became one of the few games in town and one of the companies that was most able to help every business get to this. So Shopify, from a valuation point of view, is really hard to figure out how to justify. No one argues it's a fantastic company, and they've done a lot of really innovative things, and they've done a lot for the Canadian tech ecosystem. But putting a peg on that, on the valuation, is getting a little stretched, because you're really right now paying for a lot of growth coming out in the future and making sure that they can actually make this as a profitable space, and also assure that there's no competitor that's going to come on. So I would say Shopify is a little overvalued right now, but there's no question they've done a lot to save a lot of small businesses.
We've talked about some of the most obvious names. Who else is on your radar on both sides of the divide that perhaps, we're not outrightly seeing?
I think as you're looking at technology, one of the big things that everyone's looking at is that you've got to look almost behind the scenes and where the CapEx and where this money is going to flow. And I think people have really realized that they need to build up more data centers. They need to put more of the 5G. So I think the next transition you could get as the economy starts to reopen is a shift away from the internet and the software base towards more of the hardware and the actual semiconductor companies, which are building the guts of the operation here. The other big theme that's been out there is really 5G is going to advance, and it's going to become more important than ever as more companies start to do more through a technology point of view, and they get some stress in the system. So I think money is going to be put into the system, building out the hardware, building out the CapEx. And that's where you want to look at more of the so-called value tech, the names that are really just the hardware names that haven't caught a lot of the attention. They're still trading at much more reasonable valuations. I think Micron in the US is a good name. Semiconductor company, works on DRAM, works on really putting some of the infrastructure into the system. Ericsson is another good name from a point of view that as people start going towards 5G, you really start avoiding the Huawei effect. You've got to look at other providers, and whether that's Ericsson or Nokia, I think both of these stocks could benefit from these 5G themes.